my name's Dave Stewart. I'm a fourth generation farmer here. We run an intergenerational family business. I have two sons and a daughter involved with the business as well. Today we have a sheep division, a dairy division and a tourism division. We run a Walmart five-star lodge. Originally this was all in heavy native bush, really dense bush, and the first people that came through cut the logs out, big logs for timber, and there was just so much timber here, most of it ended up being burned, and it was a real scorched earth policy for around here. And then they realised that they need a bit of shelter, so they started planting macrocarpa trees, windrows of macrocarpas, and pine trees, a few gum trees. And we live under the biggest wind farm in the southern hemisphere here by the Manawatu Gorge, and it blows. And the Waihini storm, 1968, created absolute havoc through here, blew trees down everywhere. And you've got to realise in those days, in the early 70s, that nurseries just didn't have native trees. You could, you went to a nursery and you'd buy camellias or rhododendrons or something like that, but you just, it just wasn't trendy to plant natives. Bought this property here, we've had this nearly 6 years, and it was in a, it was pretty run down to say the, to be the understatement. At that stage there was a lot of pressure coming on about fencing creeks off, so I got stuck into it, and we had a firewood contractor come in, took all the big stuff out, and then started planting it ourselves with natives. We're not legally required to do this, but I think it's just, it's what the community expects, I think. This creek actually feeds the Manawatu River, so there's a lot of talk about fencing rivers off, but it's actually, we've got to start at the fingers before it actually gets to the river. It's no good having the river fenced off if we've got a whole lot of shitty water coming in it upstream. It is a riparian planting that'll shade the water, keep the stock out from treading on the edges and putting sediment in the creek, and stock needs shelter from wind and in shade in the summer, and I think it'll be a real little paradise here. This actual farm here was one of the best stands of kaihikatias in the Manawatu. They're 150 feet high originally, and so I'm putting kaihikatias through here. This little fella here is a Mary Princess. Pahutukawa, beautiful flowering tree in the summer, not from here originally. Some people think we're wrong to plant these, but they're one of my favourites. But I like Nios, they're good hardy shelter trees, and you get a lot of underplanting under them. We buy our native trees from Kaitoki Prison in Whanganui, and you just email them and 4,000 trees arrive in a truck. It is expensive, it's 2.4k this creek. It's taken me 2 years to fence it and to plant it. Most properties between the trees and the fencing I've spent between $35,000 and $40,000 here, and I've had 50% subsidy, so up on top of, if you add that all together, it'd be $70,000 to $80,000 worth of project here. So you know, you only do it once, and once it's done, it's done. If I hadn't have had the grant from Horizons Regional Council, and I think a government from the Leaders Accord, there's no way I could have done this. I might have done one paddock at a time. You've got to have good financial years to do it. We usually set aside about $10,000 a year for riparian planting or native tree projects. We've got a responsibility for future generations to get our water right. It's not good enough. We've got to step up to the mark. Yeah. There's some things in life you can't put a value on, and this is it. Yeah.